Siamo a bordo di un gommone.
We're aboard a dinghy, but it's not a simple dinghy. In fact, we're not in the water, we're on the beach. This is Iguana X100, and it's not only a nautical means of transport, it's also a land vehicle. Basically, it's an amphibian. It has two outboards, Mercury 300 horses, and then it has a third engine, a 1,500 cubic centimeter four-cylinder, four-stroke Ford. What's the use of it? We are on the beach. We cannot use the outboards, and so we use these two levers to move. One lever forward, the other back, and the direction is combined by activating one lever more or less than another.
Oh, ragazzi, stiamo per entrare.
Come on, guys, let's go in the water with the tracks.
Adesso acceleriamo.
Now, let's accelerate and turn on the engines.
Accendiamo i motori.
This is the first time I use it, and I still need time to adjust, but it didn't seem at all difficult. While going down in the water, I lowered the outboard trims and turned them on. And now, since I no longer need the tracks, I pull them up. I just press this button, and the monitor tells me when I have finished the operation.
Engine stop.
Perfect. At this point, I could stop the Ford engine, but in case I forget to do so, the system automatically does it on its own after a few seconds. Now, we're on a dinghy like any other rib, so let's try it.
Questo progetto è nato in Normandia.
This project was born in Normandy, and it was logical that it developed in that area, where the high tides uncover and cover hundreds of meters of beach, making navigation difficult, but also the landing.
Hanno impiegato oltre 7 anni per sviluppare questo progetto.
It took over 7 years to develop this project, and only in 2013 did they sell their first boat in the Middle East. The event was such a media success that, for a long time, it was believed to be an idea and also a company of that era. Instead, we know that it comes from a French company.
I
can't imagine the endless applications of this vehicle. For example, think of those countries where there are no ports, and you can only keep the vehicles on the beach. You do not need winches. You are completely autonomous with a hull like this. It could be used, for example, for shipping to places around the world where there are no facilities of any kind. But it could also be a means of rescue on those beaches that have ports too far for the Coast Guard boats. But I like to think of it in a simpler way, as a piece for recreational boating. Suppose you have a house on the coast of a river, a lake, or on the sea, and you can access the water independently. You don't need a berth, so you will not have those types of costs, and you will not have to use anti-fouling, which we know is polluting. Iguana produces different models, including a commuter, a very elegant boat with air top, cabin bathroom. It also exists in the limo version. That's with lots of seating and cushioned seats. Earth movement can also be carried out, instead of with a petrol engine, with an electric motor. The system that manages the position of the tracks, inserted in the hull or outside to move on the ground, is very simple. It is made with an electro-hydraulic system with stainless steel elements, therefore not subject to corrosion, and the tracks themselves are nylon, therefore practically eternal.
Tutto questo è favoloso, ma
All of this is wonderful, but what we boaters want is that it is capable of navigating, and that is why we are here on board, to prove it on its true element, the sea. This boat is 9 meters and 60 centimeters long and is 3 meters and 40 centimeters wide, equipped with this terrestrial locomotion system. It weighs 3.4 tons, including the two 300 horsepower Mercury engines. Obviously, they made sure that it was very sturdy. The blanket is all built by infusing vinyl vacuum resin. The hull is made by infusion of vacuum epoxy resin, and the sandwich is practically very strong. The construction site claims that even with a complete throttle, we can pull down the tracks and nothing would happen. It would slow down its course, obviously, but there would be no damage. I personally prefer not to try this type of test. Let's use it to navigate as we would do with any other. We talked about the technology, but I didn't tell you anything about the style. It's a new product, and I have to say that they also stylize the hull. At the start, you need a little gas. We need to bring the engines over 3,500 RPM to reach the glide, but around 17 knots we sail very well. It is sufficiently soft on the waves at this speed. We're at 4,000 RPM, and right now we're already over 30 knots. Under the hull there are deflectors that serve to minimize the advancement resistance of the arms of the terrestrial locomotion system. And indeed, the efficiency is very good. The tubulars do not touch the water, but the stability of the vehicle is excellent. We try it in a turn to understand if the angle of heel is excessive, but also to understand what influence such large and heavy masses have at the lateral extremities of the hull. Let's try to make the hull situation very difficult. It's incredible, the behaviour is completely similar to that of another inflatable boat. Of course, the tracks do not hide completely, therefore in juxtaposition, they resist and the speed drops. But when you sail, it goes fast. It behaves exactly like a great hull. It fills the trim, it rises on the waves, it slides straight away, and it goes very fast. I almost can't even believe I'm on such a heavy vehicle. We're at 47 knots, and we are keeping course. Don't call it an amphibian. This is a true nautical means of transport. I think I understand why it's so stable. The terrestrial locomotion system is certainly heavy, but it's located in the lower part of the boat and eventually lowers the center of gravity. That's why it's so good. But now, another test awaits me. Will I be able to return back to the beach? Let's try and see. The boats, the dinghies, give us the opportunity to navigate where we want. Iguana also gives us the opportunity to land where we want. I don't think you can get more autonomous and freer than that.